it's impossible for God to exist, and even something like a soul is something that wouldn't even be possible.
Again, according to Sean Carroll, yes. And he's got even a physics formula for it.
So appeal to authority.
I'm sorry, what?
Appeal to authority?
No, not at all. If he's got a physics equation to it, then it's based on his math. And it's his argument. I'm not defending it.
If the soul exists, would it be physical?
It would have to be a transmission of the mind and our data and the physical peculiarities that make us doing what we are that would then have to be transcribed into some immaterial being magical form.
Try it again.
Ready? Mom, you ready?
I guess.
Three.
Just keep moving.
Two.
Keep moving to dodge the bullets when it's looking at you.
Three. Somebody started shooting already.
Jason.
Oh, they're both right there.
That's what I said. I told you that.
Yeah. It's water down below.
Is that me? Is that me?
Guys,
whoa!
Shit.
Whoa!
Don't stand still too long. They look at you. They can shoot rockets at you. So you gotta keep moving.
Right.
Yeah, but I can't aim very good tonight.
No, just
shoot,
move.
Unload your clip on them and then move. Okay.
Shooting rockets.
Reload today would be nice.
Yep.
That's one down.
Oh, in the back behind it, right here. Right there where its fire is coming out. That's
fire.
Explosive. He's looking at me. Nope, he's looking at Trevor. Okay. Nope, he's looking at you.
Looking at me. 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 No, he's looking at me.
Oh, right there, Trevor. Right where you shot him. You got it.
We should play Fortnite at some point, too.
This I can't use.
Mostly to rub it into Mitch McConnell's face that we're playing Fortnite.
Does he not like Fortnite?
I don't know. Yeah, he's how old is he?
He hasn't. Now this, I apologize. This is political, but I heard.
And what else?
That he hurt his shoulder jerking off so hard about the mass shootings.
He was jerking off to evidence in the Epstein cases.
I'm ready to fight.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
That was good.
Thank you.
Hey, welcome to Smoke and Madness. Your show that's... Welcome to Smoke and Madness. My name is Michael. I thought you weren't doing these anymore. I don't know what I'm doing anymore, man. Why don't you get off my... Why don't you get on my dick? Today we're talking about it, atheism. It's a real popular topic. I want to talk about this guy.
Doctor of the brain.
Eric Hernandez.
Originally, it was thought to be physical, yes, because the people who wrote the Bible didn't understand that air was particulate matter. But they knew that you would die if you can't breathe. So that's why translations of the Bible mix on... You wanted an answer to the question. Was it the soul? The reason that you believe you have a soul is because the people who wrote the Bible didn't know what air is.
That's the reason.
So they thought that air was spirit. So that's why...
That's why
in Ecclesiastes 3:18-21, where it says, who knows whether the breath... I'm sorry, what?
You're making an assertion again about me that is not even...
I'm not making any assertions about you.
So you're pretending to know things you don't know. Which
I'm not pretending anything. I'm giving the evidence argument.
You don't know why I believe in the soul.
The reason people believe they have a soul
evidently
is because the people who wrote the Bible didn't know what air is.
Talking to me.
Yes, and you are a people... And you believe you have a soul, and the reason that people believe they have a soul, evidently, is because the Bible didn't know what air is.
Evidently.
Yes.
So it's evident.
All the indications are, that's why, and I'm trying to give the evidence to support the argument.
That's not the evidence for the argument.
What?
That's not the evidence for the argument.
You haven't heard it. You keep shutting me up and telling me that it's immaterial.
You're talking about your argument that you're giving. Okay, that
I was giving you the evidence to back my conclusion.
Think about the way you say that you wish you weren't today.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-
Get on to my dick. Beep, beep. Yeah.
Hey, you.
Get on to my dick. Eric Hernandez is a preacher guy with about as many subscribers on YouTube as I do and growing. And he is a religious bloke. He's got a beard that is nicely trimmed. And he showed up to a debate Aaron Ra was having with this dude named, oh God, Michael something.
Recently, there's a debate between fellow apologist and friend of mine, Michael Jones of Inspiring Philosophy, against atheist Aaron Ra on the topic, is Christianity dangerous?
My opponent erroneously dismissed my entire argument as if it was all irrelevant, and ironically, the data he provided for his side was largely irrelevant to the question we were debating.
To no surprise, Aaron gives and starts talking about his typical definition of faith.
Faith is a belief that is not based on evidence.
And is something he's said in other videos of his.
Faith is an assertion of unreasonable conviction, assumed without reason, and defended against all reason.
Now, despite the fact that Michael already corrects all of these mistakes in his opening speech,
and I can find no scholar that specializes in Koine Greek who says this is what the Bible teaches.
He also criticized me for things I never said, and he ignored much of what I did say. For example, when I pointed out that Jesus himself promoted dangerous, superstitious pseudoscience, as well as racism, slavery, and estranging families for the sake of his cult, my opponent said that was just Christians behaving badly, as if Jesus is only human and an embarrassingly ignorant and poorly behaved Christian, and that I shouldn't judge Christianity based on the Christ.
So today, I have on Eric Hernandez. Now, I did a video recently where I was talking about what faith means, as I understand it, and I've been criticized by a number of believers telling me that I got the wrong definition. So we're going to go over that. And Eric, specifically, what would you say is the problem with my definition?
Well, I'd say that you seem to, as I've seen in your videos and you said in that last video, you seem to understand what the word pistis means. And I would say that is what the Greek word, that's the Greek word that's used in the Bible. So we would know that that means something like trust or confidence. Yet in public or when you have any kind of discourse like this, you say that faith is a belief without evidence and defended against all reason.
Holy shit. So, hi, it's me, Michael, and I'm editing. Editing Michael is probably going to have some notes that pre-recorded Michael isn't going to have. And one of the editing notes that I have is I've listened to the entire 1 hour and 40 some minutes of this debate. And this little Nimrod, this motherfucker who looks exactly like Billy Mays, this Billy Mays motherfucking looking piece of garbage, repeats this exact argument over and over and over. Aaron Ra explains a lot of things to this stupid asshole, and he gets and understands none of them because, like Ben Shapiro and like other people who argue like this, he has the directive is to turn the conversation back into the thing he wants to say to accuse Aaron Ra of whatever the fuck. Because again, it has nothing to do with spirituality. It has everything to do with religion makes this boy money. That's why he does it. Okay? Fuck. God, you guys are fucking dumb. You fucking sheeple. All right, see you for the next.
Look what it's done so far. What's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? What do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, dreamers, and me. All of us under its spell, we know that it's probably magic.
Okay, we can't keep going on. You know what I'm saying? We can't do this whole thing.
All right. Yeah, fuck it.
Have you been half asleep? And have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name. Is this the sweet sound to call the young sailors? A voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it. The rainbow connection, lovers, the dreamers, and me. La da da dee da da da, la da 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 dee da da.
Fuck yeah!
Yeah,
we did it, guys. We did it.
Turned out really good, guys.
Thanks for the copyright claim, Disney. God, you fucking scumbag.
Fuck you. Whoa.
Oh man, I know you like cartoons and stuff. You can buy things that Drew in the links in the description. Thanks. Thank you for buying the things. Anybody?
Nope.
If you go online, you can get the parameters for YouTube and it. Okay, whatever.
Yeah, I'm just following you guys.
And I'm just following my heart.
So Aaron Ra like goes off on him, and he goes off on him way more eloquently than I would have gone off on him.
You mentioned that in 20 years of rigorous research, you found no evidence of what you're looking for. But then when Michael pressed you on naming just one scholar who defines the word faith in the way you put it, you couldn't name one. So my question is, could it be possible that your research is maybe flawed, biased, and even maybe dangerous to the pursuit of truth?
I have conducted this experiment, as I explained, over and over and over and over again, having this exact conversation at least once a week for 20 years. Not one Christian ever has produced evidence. He didn't either, nor can you. No one can. It doesn't exist.
That's not the debate.
I demand
tonight
that anybody in this room who calls yourself a Christian, if you think you have scientific evidence to indicate your God, bring it.
So, okay, listen. I'm not taking anything out of context if I don't need to, obviously. I believe if you're going to do this right, there's like, you have to be upfront with what your sources and shit are and where you're getting it and things, because you like, you need to be the one that's being forthright with what you're discussing, rather. So, because journalistic integrity, it doesn't matter if everyone's just going to scream fake news all the time, which is, this guy seems like he's the type.
So the first thing he does is change the subject and immediately dodge the question entirely. Because remember, my question was not, has anyone in 20 years presented any convincing evidence to you that Christianity is true? But rather, how is it that in your alleged 20 years of research, how is it that you can continue to misuse and misdefine the word faith despite being corrected on this numerous times?
In an effort to fix this video so it makes more sense, one of the main arguments that Eric Hernandez is insisting on is that Aaron Ra somehow is using the Latin word for faith, piscis or whatever, incorrectly, which is completely irrelevant to what the conversation is, because the conversation is like, okay, so when you keep moving the goalpost and you never really make it clear what the goalpost is, then you can just claim that the person is confused all the time. It's kind of easy to do. You just say things in a confusing way and you try to get them in a gotcha. Again, you're either trying to boil things down into a yes or no that you can say, well, if that's true, then this. Or you're trying to make some kind of there's some other broader point that you're just trying to get to. And the thing that he's trying to stick Aranra in is that he said something like, there's no scholars that say piscis means that it is taken without whatever. But okay, so here's what it means. Piscis means faith. That's what they translate it to. So every time in the Bible it says faith, this argument too, by the way, is a Russian doll, right? So it was already a waste of time for Aranra to talk to this chode in the first place, because the entire point is to waste time. So, but this was part of a debate. And then these two guys did reaction videos against each other. And now we're doing this debate. And the two reaction videos, Aranra's basically just defines that, you know, faith is believing in something without evidence. And he doesn't, I mean, he says it in a kind of, I'm tired of explaining this kind of way, but I wouldn't say that he mischaracterizes it or says it in any way that is particularly mean. He isn't nice. I'm not going to but it's also like not anything that should be sugarcoated. He's very concise with his wording. He doesn't speak over people's heads unless they're willing to pretend to be that stupid. Okay. So this guy's not doing a Kent Hovind, where Kent Hovind literally just says the same thing over and over and over. Well, he is, but he's doing it in a Ben Shapiro type way, where he's steering the argument, and he does like these very annoying interruptions over Aranra every time Aranra tries to explain anything. And then he accuses Aranra of not knowing what he's talking about and accusing him of talking in circles because he's not actually listening to what Aranra is saying. Aranra does address all of his points. I'm sparing you a lot of it because he doesn't really pay any attention. But Aranra repeats himself a lot, gets very frustrated, and that is the entire goal. So the entire goal was to... So my point is, we need to stop debating these people entirely. I know this is like an old hat, but while I was making this video, okay, so this is now the 7th, so while I was making this video, Hugo and Jake were talking to this shithead.
Fossil record. This there doesn't is. Talk. It doesn't have a date on it. Somebody's putting
no.
their
interpretation on it.
Right? So now I got to do a whole other video involving these chuckle brains. And Kent Hovind repeats himself ad nauseum in that one, but it's like kind of a different thing. It's more of a battering ram attempt. Whereas this is like a Ben Shapiro, like he's trying to sound a lot smarter than he actually is. And he doesn't. He sounds real dumb.
So, given that Aran is still using this definition, although Michael has corrected it, and given that Aran can't believe something unless there's evidence for it, Michael rightly presses him on the question, asking for any evidence for why he continues to use this definition. So let's see what Aran says.
Do you have any scholars that specialize in Koine Greek to say pistis means denying evidence or reason?
Scholars who say that say again?
Pistis, the Greek word we translate as faith, means denying evidence or reason.
And we have demonstrations of that.
Do we have any scholars that say this is how it's defined?
I have no idea if we have scholars okay, that say so that. Well, no. I know that we have missionaries who say that that is what it
okay,
is.
Okay, are they experts?
Are
they the experts, though?
I don't know.
Watched his video. Aranra yells at Eric Hernandez and loses it. And I watched it. It's got 4,000 views. 4,500 views. And he really pads some bullshit out. There's like a bunch of memes in the actual thumbnail, and he puts in a bunch of memes. It looks like he kind of vaguely threatens to shoot Aranra because he puts in the taxi reference that's right about like right before he shoots the mirror.
But then when Michael pressed you on naming just one scholar who defines the word faith in the way you put it, you couldn't name one.
I'm standing here. You make the move.
We have conducted this experiment as
you make the move
over and over and over and over again, having this exact conversation at least once a week for 20 years. Huh? Not one Christian ever has produced evidence. He didn't either, nor can you.
You talking to me?
But he's like kind of dog whistling that he's like kind of wants to shoot Aranra. It's kind of ridiculous.
Drop it.
I'm trying. It won't let me.
Drop it.
I want it.
No. Lindsey Graham is evil, motherfucker. I'm telling you.
You know what happened? Did you see what he did? He was all super anti-Trump for like a few months before the whole thing went down when he got elected. And then he went golfing with Trump, and then all of a sudden he's like, guys, Trump is great. Like, what are you guys talking about?
He just told, you know why? Because he told him all the stuff. Yeah, he's offered him all the things that he wanted. Yeah. He's like, I want this and this. And Trump's like, oh, yeah, you'll get it all because I'm here.
No, I think it's worse than that. I think Trump was like, let me tell you something. You know that the RNC got hacked at the same time the DNC got hacked. What do you think they got on us, buddy?
Yeah, I was going to say, where do you, like, I hasn't, just, there's too many logical things.
They didn't release the RNC. Yeah, they didn't release anything. Wonder why.
Yeah.
I actually didn't know that. Well, I guess I did know that, didn't I?
The RNC got hacked as well. Why wouldn't they get hacked? Why would anyone not get hacked? If the DNC got hacked, then so did the RNC.
It's all in that old lady's emails.
So one of the things he did was he said, well, you said you've been doing this for 20 years, but how long have you actually been doing it?
One of my main accusations was how disingenuous your alleged 20 years of research seemed. And it seems like you're on this script. And if I could just be honest with you, it's very evident you're on a script because
I'm not on a script. I'm doing this freehand.
You know what I mean when I say
no. I don't know what you mean.
Well, then
I'm not on a script. I've had the exact same argument that I'm having with you over and over again for 20 years. So I'm pretty well rehearsed in what nonsense I'm about to hear. If that's what you mean, then okay. But I'm not on a script otherwise.
So here's why I say you're on a script. In 2014, you had a debate with Matt Slick. It was 5 years ago. And in 2014, you told Matt Slick, when he asked you how you know something that you were knowing, and you said, because I've been doing this for 20 years, which means you have not even updated your own script in at least 5 years. To still say you're doing it for 20 years, yet you said that in 2014, you have not updated your script. It seems like you have not really even looked into this stuff.
I became an activist in 1997. It's and so, 20 years, so, 22 years.
So then you were lying back then.
No, I wasn't lying.
Because you're
asserting
facts as though they are facts and they're not facts.
No, so I'm not. As I said, it's been over 20 years since 1997, but it's easier to say 20 than 22. It's fine. It doesn't matter. We're just rounding it.
Okay, right. But you're asserting, it's a real good way of putting it. We're just rounding it. It's not that you're on a script. No, of course not. Couldn't possibly be that. Couldn't be that you're being disingenuous or whatever. No.
Of course not. I'm an honest person. So yeah, it couldn't be that.
What's upsetting to me is that someone like Eric is pretending to be like this intelligent Ben Shapiro wannabe. And he's way dumber than he lets on. And he just does the Ben Shapiro type thing. Like, he's just emulating the guy, but he doesn't really have anything to say. He just knows he's supposed to interrupt Aaron Ra as much as possible and divert him. And to be honest, much of the debate is Aaron Ra trying to address things that he actually talks about. And then he goes, well, you never addressed this. And he goes, I addressed it when you asked over here. And then he explains it again.
That we have religious organizations that do post statements of faith saying that they will not change their mind regardless of any evidence to the contrary, scientific evidence.
No, I've had atheists say the same thing. What does that prove?
You haven't.
You have not had atheists say. Really?
That they would deny scientific evidence.
Wow. So not only do you know everything about what I believe, or rather, you know why I believe, you also know the people I've talked to in the past.
Yeah. Cough it up.
So you are making assertions as facts as though they are facts, pretending to know what you don't know, which by your definition.
You made an accusation against me and you were wrong every time.
And then
you're making an assertion about some unnamed other person who says things that nobody else would say. So yeah, I'm going to call that out. I don't believe you.
I can certainly destroy them intellectually, I guess, but I'm not a debater and I won't follow their rules, so they won't have me on and I don't want to talk to them.
Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. Saw her bathing on the roof. The beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne. She cut your
So, my brain's a little fried, and I have more footage to go through, but I can't remember quite exactly if I get to the actual points I need to get to. So, this video has taught me a few things. I hope you enjoyed it. If you got this far into the video, yeah, right. But here's ultimately the point, is these guys are like, this is like a grift, this is like a con. Most preachers are like con men on some level, you know? They're just selling you shit that isn't actually going to do anything for you. And they don't generally have to pay taxes because spirituality matters. Well, materialism literally feeds me. I literally eat materials. I am physically made of materials. My thoughts and feelings are the result of chemicals. So, what was my point with all this? Oh, right. Like and subscribe. I don't think I'm going to deal with this twerp anymore. He's such a dork. I forgot his name already. It's Eric Hernandez, right? Yeah. This guy's like just a twerp and not really worth anyone's time. And he wasted a lot of Aaron Ross time. And I hope I got some pretty decent clips. There's some clips at the end of the video of just Aaron Ross getting mad. But I didn't really have a good way to end this video. So this is me ending the video. Goodbye.
Never going to correct yourself. You should have by now. I shouldn't have to repeat this explanation so many times. So this is not a presupposition.
Whenever you see someone have quotes, some of the quotes I saw said things like appealing them to saying, you know, it's not evidence you see or something you see, as if seen is a necessary requirement for something being evidence. And you even said it's not earlier. So just because someone says that they talk about faith and then they mention things that they don't see, it doesn't automatically mean it's not evidence. And by your standards, you even said earlier, not necessarily, it doesn't disqualify it as not being scientific evidence. So, and I think that's a mistake that you were making.
Okay, I didn't make a mistake.
Okay, of course not.
Yeah, of course not. And I had, two things would have happened. One, you would have shown it. And two, I would have admitted.
Okay.
But if you can't do the first one, how can you get to the second one?
Okay.
You have to understand what you're criticizing first, and you're making painfully obvious that you don't. But thank you for, seriously, sincerely, thank you for coming on to have this discussion with me.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Tongue and slap your brains out trying to get to it.